Hello, dissenters. My name is Italix, and I am here today as the sun is rising in Unturned, ready for another day of crafting, base building, and fort constructing. But I have to start this video off with some news. I got good news and I got bad news. The good news is I have a lot of materials already crafted, ready for us to place down pillars and platforms and walls and foundations and other things in the chest room. We've also got a nice little ceiling here starting the next floor up. So this is going to be the beginning of a beautiful second story. The bad news, we have some flaws in our construction. I decided to go ahead and be snazzy and build a whole platform so that you can make a little ladder coming up through it, perhaps. And I wanted to make a basement pretty bad. And I had gone a long way towards setting that up with all these pillars. The bad news of it is I learned that you cannot build downwards in Unturned. So even though you can attach these pillars to the bottom of the platforms, you cannot attach a platform to the bottom of the pillars. I have tried for a long time, and it will not snap to, and it does not seem possible. I am very sorry about that. I'm going to have to come back and clean up the underside of our base in a different time, probably on my own, so that you guys don't have to watch it and wait for me to do everything and chop all the pillars down. It's just going to be a real ordeal. So let's start building upwards instead and think happy thoughts. All right, so let's get the pillars up and decide where we want the second story to kind of run. It's definitely going to be in this area, so I want to build up a little pillar right there. We're going to need three more pillars, well, two more for that little square. And I want to continue extending our platforms around to connect it to the other side. So this is going to go one more out in this direction. And then we're going to start cutting back over to the right and connecting it like so. Just kind of keeping a wide berth around this particular tree. And I'm going to be able to start placing some walls as well. Not sure if I should place them here. Kind of makes sense. I don't think they should be windowed necessarily. So we're going to go with solid walls. And I'm probably going to need one more in between those, but I don't know if it's going to be possible for me to make a wall there. If not, I guess it won't be that big of a deal. Let's go get our other platforms and some other little building materials from our chest here. Let me put this up. Ooh, look, a tomato. Let's just go ahead and eat that yummy tomato. Okay, we have ladders here, which are unfortunately going to be in vain, since I don't think we're going to be able to use them. Let's take the wall pieces. I don't think we need the ramp just yet. Let's take all of our pillars. Probably going to make a doorway just right here, I suppose. I could... let's check out the platforms first. Do we have any platforms? A foundation will kind of give us the same effect, I think. Will that go underground? I don't think so. So let's get it to snap too, like so. It gets rid of the grass, which is pretty cool. And look at this... this little fireplace. My little campfire is just kind of right on the corner, ready to set my building ablaze. Unfortunately, it can't do that. I say unfortunately because I would love nothing more than to set this whole thing on fire. But I digress. Let's go ahead and get some more wall pieces up. I think we could... Do we need windows here? Maybe. Maybe on this side. Let's do a solid wall on this side and a window on this side and then a doorway. That sounds good. So to make the doorway, we're going to need some supports. All right, so we got that already ready to go. Let's put it on. And we need a window also, so that's going to kind of be the same deal. The wall plus two supports. Let's get the doorway back in there, turn it into the window. And ta-da, we are now mostly enclosed, and we do have doors somewhere around here just hiding out. Let's see if we can find it. There's one door. All right. See, I told you I came prepared today. We got pretty much everything ready to go. All right, which way is the doorknob? Left side. Left side, strong side. Let's see if we can center it up nicely. Crafting continues. Gathering continues. It's a never-ending cycle. The trees just constantly diminish from my island. There's probably less than half of them left since when I started just cutting them all down. And I feel like I haven't done anything. I've placed a whole bunch of pillars, a couple walls. That's pretty much it. So we're going to start trying to make this look like I'm actually making progress here. So first things first, let's get one of our wooden platforms and try to complete this little overhead walkway here. We want to be able to walk around our entryway, like so. All right, and we can go all the way around. Now the question becomes then, do I want this to be exposed? Or do I want walls around the outer edge? So I have a couple options available to me. And I'm kind of going with just leaving it open and exposed. So that's what we're going to do. And maybe that will make more sense as I progress. But I'm still going to continue placing pillars down. on all of the pre-existing pillars, and I think that there's a good reason for that, but we'll have to wait and see if Italics is right. We want to make sure that we're not exposed. We want to not get sunburned, you know? We gotta make sure we're hiding in the shade, working in the cool breeze. What else do I have? Some walls? Now that's where Italics is playing. It gets a little tricky. We're not gonna place walls down. No, 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 no. This is gonna be the shooting gallery range thing. We're gonna have some low little barriers to hide behind a shootout, and we're gonna have a full third floor with full walls, windows, and things like that, and then we're gonna have a roost on top to snipe from. That's the plan anyway. So how best to go about doing it? There's definitely gonna be a wall here. I don't think we need a window since the tree's just gonna kinda be hanging out there anyway. We're just gonna put this all together one little piece at a time. And I also wanna make sure that we do successfully link these little platforms together. And then I also need a way to connect it over the top of the crops or around the crops. Oh my, I'm getting a little ahead of myself working on like a third floor already and we haven't even finished the little walkway here. A quick visit back to the chest does indeed reveal the ramp. Now, do I want it facing this way? I think it would be quicker if it was... This is not going to work at all, actually. Okay, I can face it to the left, and let's face it this way instead. Yeah, I like that better. Because if you're coming up from the first floor like this, you want the quickest route possible up to the top. So that's the quickest route that I can find. I like that there is a little bit of a gap there, so that you do have a walkway to get up the ramp and down the ramp without falling off of anything, so that's nice. All right, and now we want to kind of continue around the side by making some more platforms. 5 in total, to be exact, and I haven't even had to cut down any more trees just yet, so that's just great. All right, so we're gonna cover that up. Now we really have a fully sealed interior, and I don't really want to cover the crops because that doesn't make sense to me, and I can't build this way because it's a tree, and so I'm not 100% certain how to proceed. So option A is I just move the crops eventually. I like that option the best. So we're just going to cover it up for now, even though it doesn't really make much sense to me, and we're going to make a new little fertilizer place somewhere up much higher on top of our base when that time does in fact come. So let's go ahead and use the rest of these platforms in order to connect over to the side, and this is the long-awaited moment. We finally achieved a full square, rectangle, circle, just pick your favorite shape and put it in here. Now we need some pillars to make this look more naturalized, because if you look out here, you're going to see that most of this is just floating, in fact. I hope you guys are getting excited, because I am excited to finally be truly building up. We're making this base so much greater with every single block, and this is going a lot faster than it was before, you've got to admit. So, am I going the right way? Yes, I think I am. Okay, but I want to go down and make sure I don't get a little too happy with building everything. So, let's make sure we're still going the right direction. All right, we're going to need some more pillars up around here, and we're out of platforms right now. So, let's go ahead and make some pillars while I'm thinking about it. So, we're going to need some boards and supports. So, let's combine these boards. Let's make some more supports. Let's just combine these sticks, too, so now we can make a good number here, and combining them like so is going to give us the pillars. It's only 2, but I guess it's a start, so 1 and 2, and now our little platforms are in fact being held up properly. We're starting to run a little bit thin on supplies. I think we've made really good progress in this particular episode, but I'm not quite done yet. I want to make another wall, which is going to require a pillar, and I think some frames. Okay, so let's make sure we don't run too low on materials here. There is the wooden wall. And then we want to take the wall and split it into ramparts. So we're not going to be able to make many just yet. But this is going to be a start. All right, so rampart number 1 and number 2. And so our goal is going to then become to kind of do that all the way around, making sure that our little walkways are safe and secure, or at least have some level of defense. And I think it makes sense to kind of make this little space into a full-fledged wall instead of just a rampart, and just to make sure it's completely enclosed in and safe and secure from the outside elements. I'm kind of just role-playing here, guys. I know no one's going to really be shooting at me, but it's just fun to see what you can build and construct in what amounts to kind of a peaceful mode. There's not many zombies. There's not too much that's going to be troubling me, but I still like to see what I'm able to create and come up with. So I think we've made huge progress so far on this video. None of this was even here at the beginning of this episode. And of course, we've got this first floor that is nice and secure, and I'm gonna have to come back in on my own time, like I said, and fix this unfortunate basement that is just simply not going to work. But everything else is starting to look really nice altogether. We're gonna add some more walls, some more ramparts, another floor, and eventually one day maybe a crow's nest to snipe out of. So I hope you're enjoying this series. If you do and you want to see more videos like it in the future, please let me know by leaving a like on the videos that you enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.